Hello and welcome to the big picture. After 10 years of uninterrupted stint in power, the Bhupinder Singh Hooda-led Congress government in Haryana is facing a litmus test. The elections to the Haryana Assembly, which is just 5 days away, is seeing a multi-cornered contest with BJP emerging as a force in its own right. For the Congress faced with a natural anti-incumbency, it will be a tough battle. The state, which has normally witnessed straight fights, is now witnessing a multi-cornered fight, making the election predictions that much more complicated. The Jat factor, which has always played a role in the elections in the state, continues to be a major factor in these elections also. We will discuss all the factors and the personalities involved in the battle and look at how these elections may turn out. To discuss this, I have with me Sanjay Kumar, Director, CSDS and a Psephologist, K.V. Prasad, Associate Editor of the Tribune, T.K. Rajalakshmi, Deputy Editor at the Frontline magazine, Shyam, my colleague here at the Rajya TV, and my other colleague Vishal, Dahiya, who has been travelling in Haryana, is also with us. Welcome to all of you. Sanjay, I would like to come to you first. Do you see this elections any way different from what we have seen in Haryana in the past?
Oh, yes. If you look at how BJP has been campaigning and the increasing support base of BJP, because if you look at the electoral history of Haryana, BJP has not been a major power in Haryana.
They just won four seats last
they
in the last
They just won four seats, but if you look at the Lok Sabha elections result,
right,
they led in 52 assembly segments with a vote of 35%.
52 out of 90.
52, and this is 52 out of 72 which they contested. So that way, this election is very, very different compared to the past elections in Haryana.
So it is the BJP factor which is the main thing there.
Absolutely, because if you look at Congress or IND, both the parties, the main parties, besides other smaller parties, all parties are trying to attack BJP, not other parties more. So that's where BJP is at the center, and all other parties are trying to oppose BJP. So that's the change in the pattern of
this is the same pattern which we are witnessing in Maharashtra also.
Almost the same.
BJP versus others.
Almost the same pattern, BJP versus others.
Okay, I will come to the other aspects. Prasad, would you agree with that? It is BJP versus others battle in Haryana?
Well, as of now, the one thing is very clear that the campaign that the BJP has launched and sustaining in is to try and emerge as the single force in elections in Haryana. But remember, this is the first time Bharatiya Janata Party is post Lok Sabha elections is contesting a major assembly elections, Maharashtra, of course, included. The factors are slightly different in both states, as everybody would agree or know. But what is important in Haryana is INLD, which, of course, the Indian National Lok Dal of Mr. Chautala, continues to have its sway over the Jat voters, a section of Jat voters, I will come to that later part of it, and of course the rural segment where he has a good command of his vote base. So these are the two factors that people are interestingly watching, whether it will make a difference to BJP, because the Bharatiya Janata Party initially began to kind of give the signal that it was emerging as a non-Jat party. Which is an important component, because if you look in terms of caste and community, some 20%+ votes would be, is what they say the Jat community would have across the state. It could be skewed in different localities, in different segments. But they gave 28 seats to Jats, so of the 90. And of course, Mr. Modi is aggressively campaigning. The state, they say, is from Delhi to Kalka, the highway which connects to Chandigarh. On either side, the urban segment is what the BJP is hoping to encash, that Modi's popularity, which struck a chord among the youth and the middle class, would probably be replicated. Is that the way they look
at it? Okay. Vishal Dahiya has been travelling in Haryana. Vishal, is it, you know, from what we have discussed so far, both my panelists, Sanjay and Prasad, you know, is it when you have been traveling, do you see this happening? It's a BJP versus others battle?
Not exactly, Girish. If you look at the political situations or the political landscape of the state of Haryana, it cannot be termed as BJP versus others, because BJP's electoral fortunes in this particular state has not been very, on a very upward trend.
What about Vishal? What about their performance in the Lok Sabha elections?
Well, that's fine. Their performance in Lok Sabha elections has been wonderful. They won 7 out of 10 seats. But then let's not forget that these are assembly elections. And if you look at the facts and figures of the assembly elections, specifically with respect to the BJP, last time they had 4 seats. The best of their shows has been in 87 and 96 when they were contesting in alliance once with Devi Lal's party and once with Bansi Lal's party. And the highest they have crossed so far is 16 and one was 11. So that was the time when they were fighting in alliance. One of the best chances when their other alliance partner did manage to form the government and got a form, you know, wonderful numbers. So obviously, one very important factor with respect to the BJP out here is that they are contesting this elections on their own. Two, there are not too many leaders we can say, you know, from the state government's state level's perspective, but there is no single crowd puller face as far as BJP is concerned.
What about Modi? What about Modi?
Well, yes, this is one particular factor which on which BJP is banking upon. Their state level leaders are banking upon. They're hoping very, you know, resting their hopes very figuratively, collectively on Narendra Modi himself. But then he's going to address 10
rallies.
Rallies in the entire states. That's one rally per parliamentary constituency. Now, how far will Modi be able to attract voters apart from their traditional vote bank? That's the urban areas, as you were rightly pointing out. One of our guests was pointing out that it's more or less the focus is on the urban areas, most of those which fall on the either side of the NH1. But then, and then that's true as well. One of the seats which BJP won last time was from the Sonipat district. That's the Sonipat city seat. And these particular areas for last 10 years were considered the stronghold of the Congress, specifically the Chief Minister Bhupendra Singh Hooda. And despite the fact that Congress formed the government second time continuously in Haryana, the Sonipat seat went to the BJP. That was an urban seat with a dominant Punjabi or a Jain community cloud out there. But okay. Then, apart from that, it will have to be seen as to how far Modi will be able to attract voters deep inside from the villages, because those are the places, and specifically the Jat heartland, those are the areas from where BJP will have to make an inroad if they want to make it on their own this time around.
Okay. Shyam, see, you have been a long time observer of Haryana politics. You think things have changed today, post Lok Sabha elections? All the past, analysis which we are doing, that BJP had never won more than 9 seats, 11 seats. All those will have to be set aside and we have to look at this whole thing with a fresh approach.
Yeah, definitely things have changed for BJP. They have won 7 seats in Haryana. But we have to see, even in Lok Sabha elections, if we see Indian National Lok Dal, they were supporting Modi. In Lok Sabha elections, and Haryana Janit Congress was with in alliance with BJP. So because Modi was a big factor in Lok Sabha elections, so things were different in Lok Sabha elections. Now Haryana Janit Congress is not with BJP anymore, and as KV was saying, BJP generally dominates in urban areas, non-Jat areas. But then you have to see, if you talk about Karnal, there is Haryana Jan Chetna Party of Mr. Vinod Sharma in Hisar. Kuldeep Bishnoi is there. He dominates at least in that district. So the major stakes of BJP, you can see in Ahirwal, the area of Rao Inderjeet Singh, and to a certain extent Faridabad. But then there, if you talk about Faridabad, Mr. Mahendra Pratap, who is a cabinet minister in Bhupendra Singh Hooda government, he is quite influential, he is quite popular. Captain Ajay Singh is quite popular and a senior Ahir leader in that area. So things are not that easy for BJP, and we have to keep in mind that Indian National Lok Dal retained its vote share in Lok Sabha elections also. So it is not going to be very easy, and I met a few of experts in Haryana. They say that in urban areas there is fight between Congress and BJP, and in rural areas there is fight between Congress and Indian National Lok Dal. So it is a multi-corner contest this time in Haryana, and BJP it is not a smooth ride for BJP though.
Okay, that's interesting. I'm sure Sanjay will have a lot to say on all that we have discussed till now. Rajalakshmi, my question is this. BJP has emerged pretty strongly in this, very strongly in fact, 7 out of 10 seats in the Lok Sabha elections. They have been planning for this. You have travelled in certain parts of Haryana recently. What do you think has been the major, major issues on which BJP has been able to grow like this?
See, as you said, in the beginning, that it is going to be, a litmus test for Huda. But I think it's more going to be, a litmus test for Mr. Modi. And because, of the kind of results that the by-elections have shown recently, in which the BJP has not done really all that great. So I think that is why the aggression with which Mr. Modi has been sort of leading this campaign also. And as my fellow panelists also sort of pointed out, that this is going to be, multi-cornered contest, because if it were such a cakewalk, I do not think that so much of effort would be
nobody is saying it's a cakewalk, but what are the how have they worked, the BJP has worked and been able to emerge so strongly so far? What are the issues on which they have been working?
See, if you see the kind of issues which have been raised now, they're not talking about price rise at all. They're speaking about corruption, they're talking about dynastic politics, they're speaking about nepotism. Now the thing is that prior to the elections, prior to the Lok Sabha, price rise was a huge issue, and the fact is joblessness was also a big issue. But Mr. Modi doesn't seem to be talking about price rise at all. Now, the fact remains that people say, haan, achhe din aane wale hai. It will take some time for achhe din to reach from Delhi to Haryana. So that is a little bit of
the Muslim factor, though Haryana doesn't have too many Muslims.
True.
But still, you think in the Mewat region, True. You have been travelling in Mewat region, right, you've right. seen quite a lot right, of what is right. happening there. So, is that one area where they'll be able to repeat the performance what they did in the Lok Sabha elections?
True, as Shyam pointed out, the Ahirwal region, that is part of the Mewat region, that is southern Haryana, which is dry and where employment opportunities really have not really worked too well. Of course, it can be said of the entire state, but there the communal divide is the major issue. This whole orchestrated campaign on the issue of the cow protection and cow slaughter, this bogey which is raised every time, as and when elections come close, you find this bogey being slowly raised, the crescendo slowly rising.
Is it still an issue now?
It is an issue.
In this election also?
Absolutely. There is one candidate who has said so, that they're going to bring legislation on cow protection, once they get elected.
Okay. Sanjay, few factors. Now, from what my colleagues, especially both Shyam and Vishal are saying, you can't really compare the Lok Sabha elections with this election, because two important factors which Shyam was pointing out, both Haryana Janit Congress and the INLD are not with the BJP this time. They were with the BJP in the Lok Sabha elections. You think that will make a major difference? And the Jat factor, how is it going to work?
No, it is true that there are differences between Lok Sabha elections and Assembly elections. So if we are not in a position to compare the Lok Sabha elections with Assembly election, I won't even compare the previous assembly election in Haryana with the current assembly election, because things have really changed during last couple of years, during last 1.5 years, since Modi has taken the mantle of BJP and spearheading the campaign. It is true that BJP is more popular in the urban areas, but their 52 leads in 52 assembly seats based on the Lok Sabha is not only in the urban areas. It is no BJP, and if you look at what has happened in Lok Sabha all over the country,
and are they major leads or thin leads or what?
These are major leads. Look at the vote percentages.
Let him finish. Yeah.
Look at the vote estimate, percentage votes polled by BJP in Lok Sabha elections and the nearest rival. The gap is of 8 to 10%. This is a huge lead, and it is not only in the urban areas, it is spread even in the rural areas. With regard to this Jat factor, yes, that is a handicap BJP has, because BJP doesn't have a Jat face, they don't have a Jat leader to ask vote for, and there is a competition for the Jat vote. But the BJP has the advantage in that, because Jat votes will get divided between INLD and Congress.
Right, so, anti-Jat vote will get consolidated.
And in a multi-cornered contest, BJP would have a natural advantage, which would happen even in Maharashtra, and that is likely to be repeated in Haryana as well.
Yes.
So will there be a split of the non-Jat vote? This is what I want to add. A split of the non-Jat vote.
BJP won in 52 assembly constituencies in Lok Sabha elections, but we have to keep in mind that, in Gurgaon, Rav Inderjit Singh, people were voting for Rav Inderjit Singh also in rural areas. Like, they were voting for Dharamveer, who crossed over from Congress. So we have to keep those factors also in mind that, they have their own own network. And then Modi wave added up and they got, you know, huge vote. In last assembly elections, their president of Haryana BJP, Mr. Krishan Pal, he won assembly elections with the margin of 600 votes only in Tigam assembly constituency.
Okay.
And in Faridabad, he registered a victory by more than a difference with the 4 lakh votes.
And there's one more aspect, Girish, you know, because several people have crossed over to the BJP from the Congress.
Right.
You know, and that has not really gone down well with the electorate. They're saying that...
Not more than the electorate, yeah, with the party.
Look at the performance
no,
in Lok Sabha elections.
No, the assembly is different. In the assembly, it would be different.
Assembly
local candidates matter.
No, but you know, okay, Prasad, yeah. You know, we have been discussing BJP, but you know, here is a man who has ruled the state for 10 years. He has been, you know, he's spoken about as somebody who has brought in quite a bit of development as far as Haryana is concerned. You think that, you know, the anti-incumbency is something which is going to hit the Congress very badly?
Well, of course, there's no gainsaying in the fact Huda and his government is certainly, and the Congress under Huda is on the back foot. There's large-scale dissension within the party. The high command did some patchwork to ensure that the senior leaders at the last minute did not desert the ship. You heard rumblings, whether it was Kiran Chaudhary, whether it was Captain Ajay Yadav, and who are the people who are just left after Birinder Singh left. And so Birinder Singh, of course, you know, is not just a Jat leader. He is the direct descendant of Sir Choturam, the legendary Choturam. And he's also a close relative of Huda. Now, that being said, one of the biggest factors that Congress seems to be battling is the compensation for land, which has become an issue because the land that was acquired in the name for SEZs subsequently got, the SEZs never took off. Many people who kind of acquired lands for that the allegations that they were diverted for other purposes, including for commercial and for private buildings. So all that is now out in the open. People are going to vote for that. But also remember, when you talk about development, Girish, there is a serious allegation or rather serious charge that Mr. Huda concentrated more of development of Rohtak and arounds, the surrounds where his... And that is an area where also, if you remember, when I mentioned in the program, within the Jats, there is the Deswali Jats who back Huda, the Bagdis, back INLD, the Chautalas. And this has been a traditional kind of a thing, apart from the rural sector divide. And just to make another point, which we've been constantly been referring to, 52 out of the 72 seats, BJP took a lead, but that advantage did not rub off on Bishnoi, who was working with them, who was shoulder to shoulder, got 2 seats, got wiped out. And Dushyant Singh won from Hisar. And today, Mr. Chautala sent a very subtle message, rather not so subtle message, when he actually campaigned in Uchana Kalan. He kind of went and put his hand on Dushyant's head, signaling that he is going to be my successor. Now, there is a sympathy factor that you cannot discount. And remember, all politics is local.
Absolutely. No, the sympathy factor is an amazing thing in this election, especially in Haryana. Vishal, you know, Chautala was in jail. He's come out on bail. On parole, actually, he came out saying that his health was not good, and then he went around gaily campaigning all over the place. Now today, the Delhi High Court is going to, seized of the matter. Is that a factor at all that Chautala is in jail? How do people look at this? You know.
Well, it is a very, very important factor, Girish, as far as from the electorate point of view is concerned, as well as from the INLD leadership or INLD as a party's point of view is concerned. Because as far as Chautala's go, it is sort of a win-win situation for them. Till the time Omprakash Chautala is on bail, he's campaigning, he's obviously an asset to them because let's not forget that if you remove Omprakash Chautala from INLD, all the other leaders are the second-rung leaders, the second-generation leaders. They do not have that much aura or influence, state-level influence. But if at all, Omprakash Chautala goes back behind the bars, before the voting happens, that also is going to be a win-win situation for the Chautalas and INLD, because then the sympathy factor will kick in more, with a more bigger or enormous force. As far as people on the ground are concerned, as one of our panelists was saying, the Bagdi Jats, those areas where INLD has a lot of influence. Now, those are the areas wherein people do certainly have this feeling that, yes, our leader was, fraudulently sent behind the bars. As far as the other part of the Jat heartland is concerned, that's the Deswalis or maybe, those residing in other regions of Haryana, the sympathy factor might not have kicked into that particular extent. But yes, the influence seems to be rubbing off on these areas as well. And given the fact that the INL this time around, it's a multi-cornered contest. If it would have been a Congress versus INLD fight, there would have been, specific areas, specific regions where the sympathy factor would not have worked. But then this is a multi-cornered election wherein even BJP is contesting on 96, the HJCP alliance is contesting on 90 seats. So obviously, this particular factor will, even if it is rubbing on of a smaller segment of population in other areas where INLD does not have that much influence, that might, if not beneficial to INLD, then it's going to be detrimental to the party whose candidate might be in a winning position.
Okay. Shyam, this is very interesting.
This is very interesting.
Tell me what the mindset of Haryanvis. They think that he's a victim?
It looks like, because he's a wonderful orator. The way he connects with the voter, what is he saying? He says that you read the court judgment. I haven't taken money. I haven't given jobs to my family members. What did I do? I have given jobs to 2,000 young men of Haryana. And again, I'll do this and I'll go to the jail. So, direct connect. And he's a wonderful, he mixes Punjabi, Urdu. He's a wonderful orator, makes a direct connect with the voters. So, this is one factor. And another important factor that in border areas of Haryana, which connects with Punjab, Shiromani Akali Dal is supporting them. So, in that area, if we talk about Jat heartland, Indian National Lok Dal seems to be very, very strong. Barring three districts, Jhajjar, Bahadurgarh and Rohtak, which is dominated by Bhupinder Singh Hooda and, Congress.
Okay. Yes, Rajalakshmi.
In fact, precisely for these reasons, because he's saying that, that I gave jobs, and I've been penalized for giving jobs. And he has promised some more jobs
in a similar manner.
Right, perhaps. And in fact, Mr. Hooda has said that there's only one little problem here. He's told people, yes, that he can rule as chief minister from jail if he gets elected, but you have to go and meet him in jail. So I think there's a lot of wit, happening there also during elections. But this one point, Girish, I should say
very dark wit, dark.
Yeah, dark humor, but but a small thing, I think it's a BJP's serious, in fact, attempt to sort of make inroads into the Jat vote, and they have also roped in the Dr. Balyan from UP, who has a controversial role, to in fact try to campaign for the Jats in Rohtak, especially the southern Haryana. In fact, that part of Haryana where the Jats have a certain
very
small point, because in elections perception does matter, and that's happening in Haryana also, and there is a sympathy wave for Chotala. If you look at Hooda government, the old age pension, they have the highest 1,000 rupees. Even Gujarat they have 200 rupees, that's, or Punjab, neighboring Punjab, 250 rupees. But it is not paying for Haryana.
It's not paying dividends for for Hooda. So Hooda's, Sanjay, Hooda's position is hopeless in the sense that the anti-incumbency is hurting him, the emergence of BJP is hurting him, and about the Jat factor. What do you think about the Jat factor? Is it something which is impenetrable as far as Chotala is concerned, or as all the other panelists are saying, even the division in the Jat vote can happen, and what Rajalakshmi is saying?
What is hurting Hooda is both the factors. One is anti-incumbency, strong anti-incumbency against the state government as well as against the Congress nationally. Plus, there is also this attraction for both Modi and BJP. At this moment, there is an attraction. This is my perception of looking at things, that there is an attraction for Modi and BJP. As far as the Jat vote is concerned, I think INLD INLD will benefit, because if voters don't
Sanjay, my question is this. In the past elections, how important has the Jat vote been, and have Jats voted en masse towards one party or the other party?
Largely, their vote never gets divided like two ways, but it has been shifting from one party to another. So I would say 60% of any community. So 60-70% of the Jats are likely to vote for INLD in this election, and they won't go for Congress, which was the case in the previous election, that 60% of them actually voted for the Congress. So that's the case, that INLD will benefit of the Jat because of the Jat vote, because Congress is not seen as a party in contest. So,
but you see, it's very interesting because the Jat sentiment has also been played upon, you know, by Mr. Hooda. Because at the at the Kathal rally where he was booed, he specifically said that Jat pride had been hurt. Now he has done, you know, a lot for the Jats in the sense, you know, they had so many agitations, you know, for reservation, and finally they got it. And so he's used that, you know, as a major plank.
Yeah, but Prasad, yeah. My question: smaller parties. There are 3-4 smaller parties, you know, spread over different parts of the. How much will they be able to hurt the chances, or you think that are they in winning positions in any of the places where they are fighting?
Maybe individual pockets, they would be in a position to make a difference. Whether it will be enough to capture a seat, it's unpredictable, because it could be more than 4 cornered contests in certain areas. But I would like to add to what one of the panelists, I think Mr. Sanjay, was mentioning. One of the biggest factors that the BJP is banking upon, one I did said, was the urban middle class, on which Mr. Modi continues to bank upon, and the BJP is also banking upon. And also the fact that there is a division in the opposition vote. When I say that the Jats may vote one way, the non-Jats are also divided a lot. Actually, it was only during Bhajan Lal and his working where he actually consolidated the non-Jat vote to kind of bring a cohesiveness in the way they voted.
Right.
But since then, it is an experiment which never succeeded, so much so that even Mr. Bhajan Lal tried to replicate it and made his son Kuldeep Bishnoi do so in the last assembly election. It just came a cropper, because Bishnoi was simply not able to match his father's political acumen, I would say, yeah. More than skills, whatever it is. The way in which he could manage a grand coalition of non-Jats to kind of... But since then, the leadership has gone back to the Jats. And this is where the Jats would not like to leave.
Okay. Vishal, very quickly, you see a definite result coming out, or you think that this is going to be a hung assembly?
Well, as of now, the situation which is playing out in Haryana, it is quite difficult to, go ahead and see a definite result coming out, because there's too many players.
Okay.
There are three larger parties which are playing.
I think it is going to be hung assembly and Indian National Lok Dal, maybe the single largest party.
I also fully agree with this, that it's not going to be a clean sweep for any one formation.
Last words to you, Sanjay.
Single largest party, BJP, and yeah. if they fail to get a majority, maybe just short of majority.
Okay. I think on that note, we'll have to end. We are just four days to go for the elections and a week to go for the results. We'll wait and watch. Sanjay has stuck his neck out as a true psephologist. We'll wait and watch what will happen. Thanks to all my guests, Sanjay Kumar, TK Rajalakshmi, Shyam Sunder, Prasad and Vishal Dahiya. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another issue in the big picture, same time on Monday. Meanwhile, have a great weekend.